Stink and the World's Worst Super Stinky Sneakers. Gross me out. Gross me out! Stinko! Skunksville! Stink Moody was in love. In love with school, that is. It was the best day ever of second grade. The best day ever for class 2D. And maybe, possibly, the best day ever in the whole world and his entire life so far. Mrs. D was taking Stink Moody and his class on a field trip. A smell trip to the smelliest place on Earth. Class 2D was going on a special trip to the Gross Me Out exhibit at the Science Museum, and Stink had a fifth sense that it was going to be the smelliest field trip ever. Stink carpooled with his two best not-smelly friends, Webster and Sophie of the Elves, a.k.a. Elizabeth, but nobody was allowed to call her that.
Hey, guys, did you know one human being person can smell about 10,000 smells? No way, no how, said Webster. I love peppermint ice cream, said Sophie, so I guess that makes me smart. How do you know so much about smelly stuff anyway? Asked Webster. His name's Stink, isn't it? Said Sophie. No, come on, for real, said Webster. Don't forget I read the whole entire S encyclopedia. Books do not lie, especially the encyclopedia.
Class 2D followed their teacher into the museum. Stink ducked as he stepped through a pair of ugly red lips and giant chomping teeth at the entrance to the wonderful world of smelly stuff. Slimy, oozy, stinky, gooey! There were beeps and toots and blinking lights in every direction. Where to start? The vomit machine? Musical farts? The Burp-O-Meter? Stink could not decide.
I think there's a giant nose here somewhere, he told his friends. I saw the picture in the paper. Count me out, said Webster. Where there's a giant nose, there could be... giant boogers!
Said Sophie and Webster at the same time, shivering at the thought.
Well, I'm going to check out the giant nose first, said Stink. Not me, said Webster. Not me, said Sophie. Okay, smell you around, Stink said, cracking himself up.
Stink's stinky facts. Ratio. Sneezes travel as fast as a car, 40 miles per hour. The fastest sneeze clocked in at 100 miles per hour. No lie.
More fun than earwax. Stink took an up-close and personal tour of the giant nose. He got attacked by giant nose hairs, peered down a big, ugly, bumpy throat, and skipped through the hall of mucus. He even learned how boogers are made. Not pretty.
Having fun? Mrs. D asked him.
Are you kidding? This is more fun than earwax, Stink told Mrs. D. And educational, too, he added.
Grown-ups love the E word. They like to think you are learning stuff, no matter what. Mrs. D smiled.
Stink, you seem to be interested in the sense of smell. Maybe you'd like to try the Everybody Stinks exhibit. Nobody else seems to want to go near it.
Mrs. D pinched her nose and shook her head.
How smelly can it be? Stink said bravely.
Mrs. D pointed to the far end of the exhibit. Stink strolled over and read the instructions.
Match the body odor with the body parts they come from, Stink read aloud.
Before Stink knew it, the whole class had gathered around. Webster announced to the class,
Hey, everybody, Stink's going to smell B.O.
Stink wasn't so sure he wanted to smell B.O., but he hated to let Webster and everybody down. So Stink mustered up all his courage, leaned over, put his nose right up to the bottle, and squeezed. He took one sniff, then scrunched up his face, clutched his chest, and crumpled to the floor. Everybody gasped, taking in what sounded like one big breath.
Ha ha ha! Gotcha!
Stink cried, jumping back up.
What did it smell like? Sophie asked. Feet! Said Stink. It's not that bad. Just smells like dirty socks when your feet sweat and you take your shoes off. Sounds bad to me, said Webster. Stink squeezed the next bottle. Ugh, this one smells like onion, maybe garlic. Bad breath, Stink said, waving his hand in front of his face. Pee-you! This one smells like my soccer shirt! Armpit alert!
It's B.O., somebody shouted. He did it! He really smelled B.O., and he didn't even faint!
After Stink smelled all the body part smells, he moved to the next station.
Rotten eggs!
Dirt! Perfume! Mothballs! Skunk! Rotten cabbage! Dog breath! Old fish! Dead broccoli! Stink sniffed and snuffled his way through a dozen yucky, rotten smells. He made a few faces, but he guessed every single smell right.
Pee you! How do you do that? You didn't miss one, said Webster.
I just follow my nose, said Stink, sticking his expert sniffer in the air.
You always were nosy, said Sophie of the Elves, laughing.
Some people have an excellent sense of smell, Mrs. D explained.
I smell something, too, said Sophie. Hamburgers!
When do we eat lunch? Asked Webster. My digestion is empty.
Class 2D sat at the picnic tables outside, munching on sandwiches. Mrs. D passed around flyers from the museum about a stinky sneaker contest being held at the park in 2 weeks. Stink read the flyer.
The all-time world's worst super-stinky sneaker contest! Wow, check it out! Can anybody enter?
Anybody with smelly sneakers, said Mrs. D, chuckling.
Stinks are the worst, said Webster, backing away from Stink.
But my sneakers are so smelly I had to wear rain boots today, said Sophie, showing off her pink polka dot boots. I bet I can win.
My sneakers will beat the pants off yours any day, Stink told Sophie.
But you haven't even smelled mine, said Sophie.
Stink shrugged.
I'm just saying.
His sneakers just had to be the smelliest. But what if Sophie's were super stinky bad too? Or worse?
Well, I'm sure my daughter will want to enter the smell monsters, Mrs. D said, making air quotes with her hands. That's what we call her sneakers. So I hope to see some of you there in 2 weeks.
Then Mrs. D asked them all about what they learned at the Gross Me Out exhibit.
I learned that even walruses have dandruff, said Eliza.
I learned the words to the diarrhea song, said Patrick.
Let's wait till after lunch to hear that, said Mrs. D.
I learned how to say fart in Spanish, said Jordan.
Biddle.
I learned that spit is gross, said Riley.
I learned that there are more critters in your mouth than people in Australia, said Sophie of the Elves.
I learned that Stink is the best smeller in the world, said Webster.
We should call you the nose, said Sophie. You know how to smell better than a dog.
Better than an ant, said Stink.
Everybody looked at him funny.
What? An ant has 5 noses, said Stink, nodding his head and tapping his honker.
No lie!
Stink stinky facts. 250,000 stinkers. Did you know that just 1 foot contains 250,000 sweat glands and oozes up to 2 cups of sweat every day? No wonder sneakers are so smelly.
Rumpel-STINK-skin.
I'm home,
Stink called, bursting through the front door. How was your field trip? Mom asked.
You mean my smell trip, said Stink.
He reached into his backpack and handed his mom the flyer for the smelly sneaker contest.
I think it really stinks that Stink got to go to the Stinky Museum and I didn't, said his big sister, Judy. It was so way fun and gross. I learned a ton of smelly stuff.
Like what? Judy asked.
Like everybody has their own smell, except if you're twins. And guess what? We can smell stuff even when we're sleeping. And oh yeah, a boy moth can smell a girl moth a block away.
Mr. Knows-it-all, said Judy. Stink stuck his expert sniffer in the air.
Is something burning?
Ah! Said Mom, rushing to the kitchen and whisking the skillet off the stovetop. She waved her hand through the smoke. I was making toasted cheese sandwiches for you kids.
And now your cheese sandwiches are...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.